tickets. And one of the biggest national TVs is the private TV. The name is Peace TV. I'm going to record it now. Между другото, тук някой дали говори добре испански.
С Google преводач. Вече не.
Не, говори ли испански?
Не.
Okay, we're ready now. Can you turn the camera a little bit down because you have a big spot on the top of your head?
Is that there?
Yeah, that is great. Yeah, that is great now. I'm thinking first to introduce yourself, where you're from, how all this stuff happened with you, and then and I'm going to translate from English to Bulgarian, from Bulgarian to English, so we need to have small breaks, not breaks, but you know.
Slow, okay.
Yeah, you can start, yeah.
Okay, can I start now?
Yeah.
Okay, hello to everybody. My name is Enrique Villanueva.
Hi, Enrique Villanueva.
I was born in Lima, Peru, in 1970.
Lima, Peru.
In the 70s, and
yes, in the state.
Is in Lima where I started to have sightings at a very young age.
Когато бях в Лима, започнах да виждам тези странни точки в небето в ранна възраст.
At 7 years old, I have some sightings. In neighborhood with friends.
Когато бяхме 7, с моите съседи също наблюдавахме тези странни светлини в небето.
The sightings were something new for me at that age, and
това беше нещо много ново за мен.
Eventually, I have one of these sightings in the presence of many adults and the kids of the block.
Така че повечето от тези неща, които съм наблюдавал, съм ги наблюдавал с участието и на други хора, съм бил сам.
That sighting was something really big that even the media covered, and the next day we have the newspapers talking about.
Много често медиите в мястото, в Лима, където живеех, отразяваха тези странни летящи светлини.
I think that was the first time my father mentioned the UFOs, the unidentified flying objects in a conversation.
Мисля, че на тази възраст баща ми беше споменал, че тези летящи светлини всъщност са неидентифицирани летящи обекти.
He was always interested in the studies of the paranormal phenomena.
Той винаги имал интерес към паранормалното и го изследвал.
And what happened is, at some point in my teenage years, I studied his library of books related to that.
Бях тинейджър, аз обичах да чета книгите, които бяха в неговата библиотека.
I practiced meditation. Practiced also the astral projection.
И отделяне на астралното ми тяло.
And also, through meditation, I started to have sightings again at the teenage years.
Всъщност тези медитации ми помогнаха да имам по-ясна представа за тези наблюдения, които правих с тези точки.
And I was intrigued about what were those lights moving on top of me at very high altitude.
Много често се чудих какви са тези светлини, които се движат напред и назад.
Eventually, I sense like kind of like a communication, like an exchange in my mind.
Понякога, като че не ставаха някакви комуникации между мен и тях.
The first first moment was doing an astral projection.
Quando todos esses outros psicografos ou delírios eram do céu, fizeram isso para o
It was kind of like a lucid dream. I was in this place that looks deserted, a desert actually. In that place I noticed the presence of a big tree. That was the only tree standing in the middle of that desert. I walked towards the tree. And as I did that, I noticed behind the tree there was some light. When I walked around the tree, I noticed that the light was coming from this elder. This elder was emanating light from his whole body, and beside him there was a big open book. When I approached the elder, he pointed at the book, so I approached the book and looked at it. In the book I could see some symbols that I didn't know at the time. When I noticed the symbols, I backed up and I looked at the elder like saying, I don't understand what is this about. The elder pointed the book again, and as I approached again, I stretched my hands, and when I put my hands on top of it, I felt the energy. I felt like the book was alive. I felt the energy coming from it and the information. It was like sensing the information from every symbol. Like every symbol was a door open to meaning and history. I access information from the past. I saw a previous humankind before this one.
Which kind?
Like previous civilization before this one.
You mean yourself, like, or this man?
No. In that book, the history, it was coming towards me, was telling me about the history of an ancient civilization before our own.
Тези символи са показвали историята от преди и сега.
So, I was seeing images from planet Earth
от планетата Земя,
that has three moons,
която имаше три луни.
I saw wars in the past.
Аз видях много зло, много страдания в миналото.
And I knew that as I was going backwards in the book, I was seeing the past, but if I go forward, I was going to see the future.
Когато поглеждах тази книга, аз виждах миналото и бъдещето.
So I started checking the future, turning the pages, and trying to get the info from the future.
Почнах да проверявам настоящето, като сравнявах информацията, която получавах с действителността.
I didn't feel I was learning something. I felt like I was feeding myself with information.
Чувствах, че се храня с тази информация.
I sensed like I was hungry for it, but the elder stopped me.
Чувствах глад за всичко това, което получавах, но като че нещо ме спираше.
The elder separated me from the book.
След като се отделих от книгата,
And I told him that I need to know, I needed to know more, so I approached the book again. And the elder stopped me again, and he pointed at the top of the tree. You have to understand the tree was ancient, was old, and probably dead. It was white. There were no leaves, only the branches, and it looked like marble, like it was petrified.
And the дървета всъщност имаха само клони без листа.
On top of one of the branches, there was a snake sleeping.
На върха на един от тези клони имаше змия, която спеше.
And I felt this fear, so I backed up, and I realized that I didn't pass the test. I realized that I didn't pass some kind of test I was going to.
И аз разбрах, че може би това е нещо като тест.
This elder was testing me to see if I can go through this temptation.
Може би този възрастен човек, който носеше книгата, ме изпитваше, за да провери вярата ми.
The temptation of going through time.
I'm sorry?
The temptation of learning about the future and the past.
Това беше нещо като... Може би той ми пробваше да провери вярата ми за поглеждането в миналото и бъдещето.
I was discouraged. I felt sad about it because I didn't pass the test.
Аз се чувствах малко тъжен, защото ми се струваше, че не взех теста.
What happened next is the elder told me that it was okay.
Това, което се спомням, е, че този възрастен човек ми каза, че всичко е наред.
He told me that I was supposed to reach for the light and take people from the darkness.
Can you repeat again, please?
He told me that I was supposed to explore and look for the light in order to get people away from the darkness.
Той ми каза, че аз трябва да изучавам светлината и да помагам на хората да излизат от мрак.
That I was supposed to manifest strength in order to teach that to those that are weak right now.
Това ми даде сила и ми помогна да помагам на слабите.
Then I heard someone yelling in my room and I woke up.
Спомням си, че някой крещеше в стаята ми и аз се събудих.
My cousin was sleeping in a bed beside me.
Който спеше на съседното легло.
She woke up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom and then she saw these two beings made of light on top of my bed.
Тя се събудила посред нощ, за да ходи до туалетна, и тогава е видяла тези две същества с бяла светлина над неговото легло и това е изплашило и тя затова е изкрещяла.
When she noticed those beings, she started yelling and she woke me up. I opened my eyes and noticed some silhouette of light beside my bed.
И когато ме събуди, аз видях просто два силуета над леглото си.
I calmed down, she calmed down, and then I asked her, and she told me what she saw. I was amazed that at the same time I was having this meeting with the elder, it was actually something in my room, something apparently physical that I have witnesses.
Аз бях много изненадан и впечатлен, че това, което ставаше в моя сън или по време на моята медитация, всъщност беше толкова реално, че друг човек е могъл да види тези същества.
I think it was the first time where when the non-ordinary reality touched For me,
mi se čita da si ponekad gledati nešto super nevjerojatno se već slučao.
When it touch my reality, yeah.
Gledati, so, tazi realnost da postane možda realnost.
Now, from there, I take my practice of meditation.
Това беше един от първите ми опити за медитация с такава положителна случка.
And I kept having the sightings and also the lucid dreams.
Аз продължах да имам тези наблюдения на тези летящи светлини и да сънувам.
Later in 1988, I went to the Rama group. And Rama is a group of contact in Peru.
През 1988 или 1989 каза, с група от хора ние отидохме да провеждаме контакт.
They were working in Peru since the 70s.
С тази група от хора ние се срещахме през 70-те в Перу.
And they talk about this contact with beings from our solar system and outside our solar system.
От тогава си спомням, че те говориха за контакти с същества от нашата слънчева система и извън нашата слънчева система.
I wasn't sure what I was gonna encounter in this group.
Аз не бях сигурен. What about this group?
I wasn't sure what I was going to find in the group, but eventually I noticed that the information I carried was the same information they had.
Аз не бях сигурен, ако тук в Америка можах да намеря група, с която да можем да правим подобни контакти, каквито правихме в Перу.
They knew about the book that I talk about in this lucid dream.
Who knows about this book? Кой знаеше за тази книга?
I didn't get you. What was
who knows about this book? You said they knew about this book. Who?
The Rama people, the group of contact.
From Peru or from USA?
From Peru.
Тези хора от Перу през 1988 година знаеха за тази книга, за съществуването на тази книга.
Yeah, we share many information in common, so I feel like I was
part. Ние споделяхме информация помежду си.
And eventually I have the sightings with them.
И аз имах тези контакти с тях в Перу.
And as I advanced in my preparation, I had physical contact with those beings.
И това беше нещо като подготовка да имам физически контакт с тези същества.
I don't know if there is something specific you want to ask me about this.
Пита дали има някакъв специфичен въпрос, който да пита.
А имал ли е физически контакт или само?
Той каза, че имал.
Can
you share with us about your physical contact with these beings?
Okay, the first one happened.
What stana се случи?
When I was trying automatic writing.
Когато се опитвах да правя автоматично писане.
What happened is I was using a paper and pen, waiting for a telepath communication.
Бях се сложил ръката на лист хартия, очаквах за телепатична връзка.
As I tried that, I felt some energy running through my head and shoulders.
Докато чаках това да стане, почувствах нещо в главата ми и рамената ми. Нещо като енергия.
I felt the energy and the presence of someone in the room, but then nothing happened.
Почувствах присъствието на някой в стаята, но всъщност никого не виждах.
So I tried again the next night at 11 p.m. exactly.
На следващата нощ аз опитах отново в 11:23 часа.
I have similar experience, the energy running down, the presence of someone, but I couldn't see anybody. Имах
енергия, която като че минаваше през главата ми.
the third night that I tried at the same hour at 11 p.m.
На третата нощ пробвах отново в 11 часа.
As I was waiting to receive something telepathically.
Очаквах нещо да получа като телепатична връзка.
I sensed very strongly the presence of someone in the room.
Почувствах много силно присъствие на някой в стаята.
I then opened my eyes and turned to see if there was someone with me.
Погледнах назад и видях някой, който стоеше зад мен.
I was expecting to see my father or my brother who maybe woke up in the night. But nothing happened, so I closed my eyes and continued trying the communication.
Същество, затворих очите си и си опитах да направя контакт.
As I closed my eyes, I immediately saw through my mind's eye some hands approaching me from the back.
Когато затворих очи, аз почувствах, че сякаш виждам чрез челото си две ръце, които бяха зад мен, над главата и зад тела ми.
As the hands approached me, like this, I saw the energy coming from the hands into my skull.
И аз можех да видя енергия, която стоеше от ръцете на това същество. Just a moment,
I felt that energy.
Just a moment, question.
Може ли да ни опише как изглеждат тия същества и казали ли са откъде идват, кои са?
Question from the public, from the TV. Question is, did they tell you who are they and where they coming?
No, not at that moment. Not in that first encounter.
В този момент си още нищо не бяха казали. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
So the energy was running from the hands into my skull with a buzzing sound.
През черепа ми. И, да.
It was like a buzzing sound, like
bzzz. And buzz.
And in the third sound, I felt like an explosion of light in my forehead, like a big flash of light.
И когато това блъскаше, аз усещах нещо като експлозия от челото ми, от светлина.
And then I opened my eyes, and then I saw this being standing in the other side of the table.
И тогава отворих очите си и видях това същество, което стоеше срещу мен.
This being was tall, maybe like 6 foot 2 or 1.
Беше доста висок, 6 фута.
His body was muscular, like a bodybuilder type of guy.
Мускулисто, силен човек.
His hair was long and white to the level of shoulders.
Бяло и дълго достигаща раменете.
His features were like a Mongol guy with big Chinese eyes.
Имаше като че ли монголино лице, като очите на китайците.
And he was wearing this kind of like a robe, very fine robe covering his body.
Той беше облечен в една бяла роба, която беше от много фина материя.
Surrounding his body was a contour of light.
И около стоеше някаква светлина.
So he was standing there in front of me. I was really scared at the moment.
Той стоеше пред мен и аз не се бях сплашен.
So what I did to break the ice was asking him, are you gonna say something? Are you gonna dictate something so I can write?
Тогава аз го попитах, ще ми кажеш ли нещо или ще издиктуваш нещо, за да го запиша.
As he was looking at me, I felt some energy coming from him.
Когато ме гледаше в очите, аз чувствах как някаква енергия идва в мен.
I couldn't see that energy, but I felt it strongly coming from him and embracing me.
Нещо физическо като енергия да идва, но аз просто го чувствах.
As that energy embraced me, I felt
тази енергия ме прегледа.
I felt his feelings of fraternal love towards me.
Почувствах неговите чувства към мен и тази вечна любов.
My brain immediately translated that feeling into the words, little brother.
I'm sorry, can you say this last part?
My brain translated those feelings that were coming from him into the words, little brother.
И мозъкът ми моментално преведе тези чувства, които получих в съзнанието си, като думите мой малък братко.
It was like he really felt that I was his brother, or he really felt that fraternal love. He was not lying to me, and I didn't have any doubt that the feeling was real.
Аз нямах никакво съмнение, че това се случва в реалност.
And I noticed that telepathy is not the transmission of an idea only.
It's also a feeling. Че телепатията е просто някаква трансмисия, предвижване на мисли.
It's not only an idea, but a transmission of feeling.
Но всъщност това не е само предаване на някаква мисъл, но също и на чувства.
And the feeling is a more complete way of thinking.
Чувството е много по силно изразяващо определено нещо, отколкото мислите.
That's what I felt. Everything that he was emanating through feeling, I translated into my language.
Всичко това, което чувствах, го превеждах чрез мозъка ми в вид на някакви думи.
So telepathy doesn't have anything to do with language. It's actually feeling.
Така че телепатията не е свързана с знанието на език, а просто с общуване чрез чувства.
And your brain translated into the language you already know.
Когато получаваш телепатично послание от някой, ти го получаваш на езика, който знаеш.
He told me he was in the need to calm down because I was not the person prepared to receive the telepathic communication.
Той ми каза, че е дошъл тук, за да се срещне с мен, защото аз съм бил готов да приема това телепатично послание.
And he told me that I was supposed to go with the group and explain what happened to me so they can try.
И той каза, че аз трябва да отида при групата и да им разкажа за това, което се е случило.
He told me that in between my group there was one that already has the telepathic channel open.
И той ми каза, че още някой от тази група също има отворени канали за телепатия.
And he told me that every time that I predispose myself to this practice in service to others, they will be assisting me.
Той ми каза, че всеки път, когато помагам на хората в различни ситуации, той ще ми помага.
At that point, he just kept quiet, and I was blank. I didn't know what to ask at the time.
По това време аз бях в пълно изумление, не знаех какво да питам и да кажа.
Of course I have thousand questions, but at the time I was really shocked. Аз имах хиляди
въпроси, в този момент нищо не се сещах, което да питам.
I was so shocked that I didn't remember any of my questions.
Бях толкова шокиран, че не си спомнях нито един от въпросите.
And then he looked at me, and then he smiled.
И видях усмивката.
The light that was surrounding his body became brighter.
Светлината, която обгръщаше тялото му, стана по-светло, по-блестящо.
As the light became brighter, his image shrunk in middle of the earth.
I don't understand what means shrinking in the middle of the world.
As the light became brighter, the image I was looking at just reduced in size until it became a spot.
Светлината толкова се е разширила, че той е погълнала образа от лицето.
and he just vanished in Middle Earth.
He took out and he disappeared?
He disappeared in front of me.
Okay. Значи, след усмивката, светлината се е разширила толкова много, че е обхванала лицето и, нали, той, и, всички, и тялото, и той не може да види всички тези детайли, след което светлината е изчезнала и той е изчезнал.
That was the first time I have the physical encounter with them.
Това беше първият път, когато имах физически
My perception was that he was physical.
Did he told you where from it's coming or not yet?
No, in Rama, this type of beings we associated with the people from Orion.
What is Orion?
Orion.
Ah.
Orion's belt. Orion.
Yeah. Това същество от този тип идвали от Орион.
He didn't say that, but in Rama, when we see this type of being, we know they are actually from Orion.
Когато видим същества от този вид, ние знаем, че те са от Орион.
When I went back to the group, I explained what happened, and the group practiced the automatic writing.
Когато се върнах да обясня това, да разкажат, да споделя това с групата, те, they had this ability, everybody had that ability to writing.
No. We, okay. In Rama, we call antenna to the person that has an open channel for telepathic communication.
Oh, the other guy who had that ability. The other guy from the group, you said before that there's one more guy with open channels for telepathy.
Yes. I explained to the group what happened in order for them to practice, but then one of my friends, Victor, he was the one that received the information.
Okay. След като той обяснил, споделил с групата какво се е случило, този другия човек, който има отворен канал за телепатични контакти, той е започнал да пише.
Through Victor, we received lots of information through automatic writing.
Получихме доста информация. What kind of information? For what about? The kind of
invitations to go. What did you say?
No, just say Bulgarian.
Mostly invitations to go to some specific locations.
Информация за това на кои места трябва да ходим.
Yes, the focus of those telepathic communications were about our expansion of consciousness, about the growing of humankind.
Те ни даваха информация за това как да развиваме човешкото съзнание и да помагам и това човечеството да става по-добро.
And from time to time we have close encounters with them.
И от време на време, по време на тези контакти, ние имахме близки срещи с the third kind.
Third, fourth.
Имахме близки срещи от трети вид, четвърти вид. Do you want now public to start with questions and then maybe conversation will be much better?
Sure. Okay.
Имате възможност за въпроси.
Еми сега, той като е от Перу, какво знае за Наска, фигурите от Наска и дори е тези същества всъщност за тия фигури?
Do you know something about Naska pictures? And have you asked these beings about these pictures? Who made them?
I personally haven't asked, but some people in Rama did.
Аз лично не съм питал, но някои хора от тази група, която се нарича Рама, се питали.
And what they say is that this was some kind of ancient airport for the spaceship.
Това, което те са им отговорили, че някакъв вид летище за космически кораби.
In the past it seemed these ships land on that location specifically.
В миналото изглежда тези кораби са се приземявали там.
the Indian Nazca people that populate that region, they live
there. Древните хора на Nazca вярват. They believe in what? I'm sorry.
They knew these beings, and they have drawings of the ships and of the beings in some ceramics, old ceramics.
Тези древни хора от Перу са виждали тези същества и те си ги рисували по глинените си съдове.
And also in stones where you can see the ships and you can see the beings.
Или те са ги рисували по камъни, като са изобразявали това, което са виждали, кораби и същества.
So that's all I remember about the Nazca line.
Така че това е, което мога да ви кажа за тези снимки на Nazca.
But definitely the lines were made to be seen from the sky, not from the land.
Но определено тези рисунки са правени чрез връзка от небето, въздуха. But what mean, I mean, there's many different pictures like giant animals. How did giant animals can connect with to make sign for this landing of UFOs? Въпросът ми беше, там има рисунки на огромни животни и защо точно огромни животни трябва да бъдат някакъв знак за тези кацането на едно?
It seems those figures are actually pointing to different star systems, are like constellations.
Изглежда като да е, че тези рисунки на животни са посочвали различни звездни системи.
Yeah, you can see a whale, a hummingbird, and they are actually pointing to a specific stars in the sky.
Или всъщност тези рисунки, някои от тези рисунки посочват локацията на определени звезди. We have people who is astronomers in this hall right now. Maybe they'll have some questions. Имаме хора от астрономи в тази зала, може би те ще имат някакви въпроси.
Mi conocimiento, my knowledge of the constellations is really poor. What I know is only the references they gave me in the group or with Maria Reich. She was a German woman that was in charge of taking care of the lines. And when I met her, she told me that the lines were actually kind of like a calendar. In her perception, as an anthropologist, it was a calendar.
And now, един от членовете на тази група е била жена, която се казва, Мария. И всъщност нейната работа е била да се занимава специално с тези рисунки. И той казва, че според нея, може би това е и някакъв вид календар.
Въпросът, групата Рама е кръстена на някого, нещо означава или къде наименованието?
Why you, how and why your group was named Rama? What means Rama? And why Rama?
Well, they say Rama is kind of a vibration.
Рама е някаква вибрация.
It seems is related to the sun.
Която свързва вибрация, която се свързва с слънцето.
The syllable Ra is related to the sun and Ma is related to the earth.
Символа Рам нали, се свързва с слънцето, а Ма с земята. И връзката, нали, Ра, Ма, слънце, земя.
Анаграмата означава
Мария.
Аз искам да
питам.
Just a moment, question.
Това, което той е почувствал и е преживял, нещо стимулирало ли го е и проявил ли активност да изучи малко повече, примерно за Слънцето, за Луната, за съзвездията. В смисъл, той потърсил ли е астрономията в неговите така телевъщични...
After everything you feel seen, have you ever had interest to learn more about the stars and the space, universe, like astronomical knowledge about the planets, stars, universe.
If through them I get that information?
No. The question is...
Is that what you were asking?
No. The question is, after everything you saw, you feel, you touch, did that provocate you to start learning more about the space, about the planets, about the sun, the universe?
My curiosity was ignited for sure, but I was more into exploring my mind and the potential of the human mind. More than looking outside into the star systems, I went inside.
Мой период, писто всъщност беше насочен повече за към това да изучавам човешкото съзнание и да се опитвам да го разширявам. Аз не знам дали това има някакъв смисъл на български.
Да.
Това отговаря на въпросите или?
Да.
Аз искам
отговор.
Колко човека са приблизително в
групата?
За каква активност говорим? Колко хора имат в групата?
How many people you have in your group, the Rama group? How many people?
Again?
How many people you have in this group, Rama?
In Rama, at some point, Rama was a population of 100,000 people around the globe, in the Spanish community, in the Latino community.
Една голяма група от 100 хиляди души от цялата планета. Земя.
А той с какво се занимава в момента?
What exactly are you doing personally right now? What is your job?
What is the job I do as a professional?
Yeah.
I'm a hypnotherapist.
Той е хипнотерапевт.
А това повлияло ли му е тези
срещи? It's like clinical
hypnosis. Стане хипнотерапевт.
How you got this decision? Maybe your contacts make you to start this job?
No, I was always interested in the study of the mind. Through the experience, my curiosity was even ignited more.
Всичките ми преживявания, които съм имал, всъщност ме подтикнаха да все повече и повече да изучавам.
In some of the experiences, they try to awaken in us some dormant senses we have, and through meditation and some practices of breathing, we could open those channels in ourselves in order to see and feel things like a clairvoyance kind of thing.
Това, което практикувам за себе си, това, което правя с хората, които искат да развиват своето съзнание, е да ги уча как да дишат, да медитират и да отварят тези канали, които има всеки човек. Всеки човек има такъв потенциал. Another question.
Искам да повторя същия въпрос, който вчера към господин Клифър Стоун, на въпроса, знае ли или смята ли, че извънземните са иерархията, служителите на Бога Творец, той каза да, те се молят също на него, което означава, че отговаря на този въпрос. Какво е негото мнение? Чувал ли това? Защото имаме много документи по този въпрос.
The question is kind of religious, and the question is, do you think if angels is servant of God? Or maybe they serving of extraterrestrial beings?
Тъждественост между ангелите и земята.
I know the first time I met one of those beings, the first impression I have was like, this guy looks like an angel. And I thought that if I have the same apparition 2,000 years ago, for sure I was going to think that this guy was an angel.
2000 години, вероятно, и ако бях видял такова същество, сигурно ще да кажа, че е ангел.
In our technological era, we understand disapparition as a visitation from another planet.
Посещението от други планети.
Because that's a filter of reality in our times.
Посещението от други планети и ние като част от този свят имаме друго възприятие и съответно друга интерпретация на това, което виждаме. Според нашата нагласа и
свят.
Мисля, че тези същества
I think these beings are visiting us for thousands or hundreds of thousands of years.
Мисля, че тези същества ни посещават от стотици хиляди години.
And I think they were pointed at as angels in the past.
И мисля, че хората от миналото са ги възприемали като ангели.
Означава се също. Директно отговор.
Thank you.
А той спомена, че те са от Орион. Кой е Орион? Звезда? Планета? Звезда или планета? Защото за нас Орион е съзвездие с много звезди, които нямат нищо общо помежду си.
You mentioned before about Orion, that these beings, they coming from Orion. What is Orion? It's a star or stars or what is it exactly?
Orion.
Right, yeah. Right, yeah, sorry.
Okay. Orion is a star system. It's a conglomerate of stars. There are many stars important there. Like the main stars are the stars from the Orion's belt. Betelgeuse, Bellatrix, Rigel.
Той спомена три звезди.
Сега те идват от Орион, това какво значи? От някоя звезда.
Съзвездие казва.
От
съзвездието. Съзвездието е сбор от няколко звезди, като едната от тях е
най-важна.
Иван, тези звезди нямат нищо общо помежду си. Те просто виждаме. И затова го питам. От къде по-точно идва?
From which star especially they come?
Ригел. Ригел.
They understand. I don't understand anything about this star. Public understand.
Хуманоидни ли са? На Ригел има сведения
за... Yeah, we got it. R-E-G-E-L.
На Ригел, според наша литература, има голяма популация от неком, смисъл,
нечовеко...
Или какъв тип, там доколкото разбирам, е била концентрация на тези, които са с...
Монголината?
Не. Дръг, които имат дръг от дръг...
Рептилоидни.
One gentleman from the public asking about these beings, he said how they look exactly like us, or maybe like the reptiles, or like the dragons.
No, they look very human, and actually like very beautiful humans.
Те са много красиви човешки същества. Те не изглеждат като жара.
В тази книга, която той е чел за древната история, какво се казва? Човечеството се е самосъздало или човечеството е пренесено на Земята?
You mentioned before about this book and the symbols. And the question is, what you saw in this book, like human race was brought to the planet Earth or was created in the earth. Do you got information about this?
Yes. It's not that these beings look human. It's actually that we look like them because we are related.
Yeah, we got this, but the question was about the when you look in this book, the first time you saw the open book with the symbols for the past, presence in the future. Have you saw in this book information about the planet Earth and the human race. The human race was brought from another universe or wherever, or was created in the planet?
We were seeded in the planet Earth. They mixed their own genetics with a hominid from this planet. And as they mixed the genetics, we became the race in planet Earth. But we are actually related through our DNA with them also.
Имаме като ДНК някаква връзка с тях, обаче нашия дом е Земята.
Той каза, че тук изнесе генно инженерство, всъщност се обръщаме.
Знае ли нещо за Пешметен и какво отношение?
Какво е Пешметен?
Пешметен, това е древна магистрала, която минава покрай Орион. Дали знае нещо за това и дали може да каже по отношението с прямо?
Have you heard? The question is interesting, strange for me. The question is, do you know something about Huawei, which passing through the how? Can you explain this to Orion?
Orion.
Today.
Does that make sense?
If I know what?
Have you heard something? What
Pesh-meten.
Have you heard something about Pesh-meten? Or maybe it's different pronunciation, but Pesh-meten, it's kind of like roads, highway, maybe star portal. Have you heard about this?
A star portal from Orion?
Yeah. Have you heard about Pesh-meten?
Okay, what we know from Rama is that these people from Orion, they create a colony inside our solar system in one of the moons of Jupiter, and they have a portal right there.
Hold on, hold on. Can you repeat again, please?
What we know through the Rama experience is that these people from Orion, they have colonies inside our solar system.
Тези същества от Орион имат колония в Слънчевата система.
In the moons of Jupiter, we have a big portal.
Юпитер има ли луна?
Да, 90 луни има.
Добре, той каза, че на one of these moons, Jupiter,
на някои от тия луни има портал.
Портал, да, окей.
Yes, it seems that this whole, how you call that, this sector of the galaxy is related to an experiment they have, and we are supposed to be an important part on that experiment.
Who made this experiment? What is the name?
Danish.
I'm sorry?
The aliens. There is a federation of intelligent civilizations out there, and they have this project of evolution, which the planet Earth is part of.
And they are from Orion?
Some of them are from Orion. Some are from Pleiades, from different locations.
Значи, част от тези същества от Орион, плюс някакви други, са провеждали експеримент. I'm sorry, when they made that experiment?
Experiment е така за еволюция в това участие.
Okay, do you want... we have to finish with our conversation because time is gone, but what can be your final words for today with us?
I would tell the people that there is no reason to be afraid of a visitation that the intentions are good. That we are actually related and maybe we are really brothers or we have brothers in space.
Ние имаме много силна връзка с тях и всъщност буквално ние можем да се наречем братя и сестри с тях.
they can probably guide us through these moments of evolution in our technology.
По време на нашата еволюция те са ни помагали от време на време и са ни водили.
If we are open enough to receive this information, we can evolve.
Да получим тази информация.
We can evolve to the point to be part of that federation of extraterrestrial civilizations.
Ние можем да бъдем и част от тази извънземна система и да комуникираме.
And the most important contact is not the contact with them, but the contact within.
The most important is what? I'm sorry.
The most important contact is not the contact with them, but the contact with yourself.
Най-важното всъщност е не твоя контакт с тях, а по-скоро контакта с себе си.
When you contact yourself, the contact with them is a consequence.
Когато ти разбереш кой си, тогава те ще контактуват с теб в резултат, като последствие от твоето разбиране за себе си, те ще контактуват с теб. Дали има смисъл?
Добре.
So go inside, look for your own potential.
Когато погледнеш себе си и видиш твоя потенциал и го развиваш,
explore in yourself and the contact with them is going to happen.
И тогава този контакт с тях ще стане.
That's my message.
И това е посланието ми към вас. Thank you very much, Enrique, and we wish you good night and good sleeping, and I apologize
thank
again.
You.
Много се извинявам за превода, аз не съм професионален преводач.
Добре,
добре.
Нищо не разберам, от самите звезди, планети, знам къде е.